David, first of all, if I had told you a week after the lockout you were going to have a scrimmage here and 18,000 people would show up, you'd have to turn back a couple thousand, would that have just blown you away? I mean, did you see that coming?
No, I didn't see it coming. We didn't see it coming. If there's a way to be surprised and not surprised, that's what we were. I mean, it's like it was a validation of everything that we've worked towards over the past, you know, 5 or 7 years, but it wasn't anything we expected. So to see it was gratifying. It was great to see the connection that we've been able to establish with the community in Pittsburgh. It was great to see how young the fans were. It was a lot of young fans. People who don't get a chance to come to the games because we're sold out. Some of them for the first time being in the Consol Energy Center. So yeah, it was extremely gratifying.
Well, what have you done as an organization, maybe not with the lockout in mind, but to ensure your fan base stays with you? I mean, there must be the steps you've taken prior to this lockout to get this result.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's not something that we did yesterday to get a result today. It's something we've built over time, and I think it starts with Ron Burkle and Mary Lemieux and their commitment to winning. Their understanding that owning a hockey team in Pittsburgh is a privilege, and it's not just owning a business. It's about more than that. It's about a connection with the community. It's about a connection with your fans. And I think you see that throughout the organization, on every level of the organization. So I think it starts with ownership. It's about the connection that we've established with our fan base. It's about the commitment to winning, and it's about the commitment to Pittsburgh.
Well, even you have to admit it's a very unique connection. I mean, I think the Penguins were ranked as one of the top fan-friendly teams in all of, not just hockey, but professional sports.
Yeah, it is a unique connection, and I think we're fortunate in Pittsburgh. I mean, because we've had the success of the Steelers setting the mark for that fan connection over the past 4 decades. So we've been able to see that, and it's different in Pittsburgh for the Steelers than it is anywhere else also. So Pittsburgh has a legacy for its sports teams of winning, number one. And it has a real deep-rooted pride in anything that comes from Pittsburgh. The great athletes that we've had come through Pittsburgh, the great athletes that we've produced in Pittsburgh. I grew up here. I know who the quarterbacks were that were from Brookline or from Beaver Falls and were from all around Pittsburgh. We all do. So I think there's a pride that Pittsburghers have towards their sports teams. I think that's evident in how they root for the Steelers, the Pirates, the Penguins, Pitt. And it's deeper here than it is in other cities.
You haven't made $1 this season because of the lockout, yet you are offering free concessions, selected concessions, half price off merchandise tonight, a lot of giveaways. Why are you doing that when you know full well people are going to come back?
Yeah, I mean, it's not about whether or not they're coming back. I mean, it's we've been doing things like that every year for the last 5 years. So it's we didn't have the opportunity to do it because of the lockout. So now what we have to do is we have to kind of condense the kinds of things that we like to do with our fan base, and we've been able to do it with the excuse of the first 4 games of a shortened season. So, I mean, our players deliver season tickets to season ticket holders' houses. We weren't able to do that this year. We usually open the season with a big screen outside and have a big party around it. We weren't able to do that this year. So there's a lot of things we weren't able to do, so we have to try to squeeze them into a shortened season. And it's just a good thing to do for our fans.
Obviously, it comes down to the product on the ice. And I was reading this morning, you were saying you're going to do what it takes to be successful, to bring that cup to Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
How deep is that commitment? I mean, obviously, locking up players long-term, I mean, how committed are you to doing that?
As committed as you can be. I mean, like I said earlier, it starts with ownership. I mean, ownership wants to win a championship. Our fans want us to win a championship. We'll do what we can to do it. I mean, it's hard to win a championship every year. But the one thing you can be assured of is the Pittsburgh Penguins will have a commitment to doing what we can to put ourselves in a position to win year after year after year. We may not win every year, but we will position ourselves to win, and we'll try to do the best we can to put the best product on the ice.
Well, are you feeling that pressure this year? Because everybody says this is the team that's going to walk away with the Stanley Cup this summer.
Yeah, I mean, Dan Bosma said it a couple weeks ago. He said it best. It's much better for people to think you're going to win than to have people thinking you're going to lose. So we'd much rather have people have the expectations that we're going to win. But I can assure you, those outside expectations are nothing more or less than the expectations we internally have of ourselves. So we don't need to see any rankings. We don't need to see any prognostications. We know that from our ownership, the goal is to win a championship, and we know that from the beginning of the year on every level of the organization. And we don't change our philosophy because of that.
Let's look ahead to the future now, and not just the on-ice product, but there's a lot of things going on around here. You got a big lot of land across the street. Can you look into the future and tell us what's ahead for the organization in terms of growing not just the sport but the business in this new dynamic with obviously the big lot of land across the street?
Yeah, I mean, I mean, from the business perspective, I think it starts with growing hockey in the region, and we've done a lot in youth hockey in Western Pennsylvania, and you've seen a lot of the fruits of that labor from when Mario was here, when there was 6 rinks in the area, and now there are 33. You had 4 kids from Pittsburgh on the World Junior Championship team. I mean, that's unprecedented when you think about it. It's like having 4 kids from Pittsburgh on the Olympic gold medal team. It's a lot of good hockey players coming out of Pittsburgh. So we're seeing the fruits of that labor, expanding hockey, making it part embedded in the culture of Western Pennsylvania, which I think we're getting towards. From a business perspective, in the development across the street, I mean, it's more than just a parking lot and a development opportunity. Being at the central point of the region, it's an opportunity to change the region and to have a dramatic impact on Pittsburgh. So we're looking at it very carefully. We're partnering with the downtown community, with the Hill District community, with the uptown community. We're going to do the best we can to put a world-class development across the street. And that's going to be probably a mixed-use housing, retail, and office space. And hopefully it'll be one of the more energy-efficient developments you'll see.
How soon do you see that happening? And also, will that also include the Hill District? That's been a big concern, where the Hill District will be part of that development.
Yeah, it's the timing of it is, we're starting the process of bringing developers in. We just finished the demolition of the arena, less than a year ago. So it's going to be a development that's over 10 years. It's going to take 10 years to finish. As far as the partnership is concerned, we're very much looking at partnering with the Hill District and the downtown. It's basically a connection point between the two neighborhoods. We've put $1 million into a grocery store that's the construction has started already on Center Avenue further up in the hill. We've put money into the YMCA that's on Center Avenue. So it's not just about developing across the street. It's about putting structures in place in the center of the hill to transform the community. And we've been very active in doing that.